Hello, and welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to a Beyond the Summit presentation of the Starletter I-League Chinese Division. Here we have the lower bracket playoff match final between CDEC Youth and The Wings Gaming. Here is game two of this best of three series, with actually Wings leading up 1-0. They were able to really just compress the map extremely well, show strength in early team fights, and make some great pickoffs happen against the Ember Spirit while avoiding those that the Invoker was trying for. So all in all, great team play, just defining the game, and now we're going to be looking into Game 2 to see if CDEC can bring it back. I would say they were the favorites going into this, so there's still a great chance of that, but let's jump into the draft and see how it's panning out. Once again, I'm Blaze. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll bring in Hades, my co-caster, to talk about the draft.
10 seconds remaining.
Okay, I think Wings. Yeah, I mean, you said CDEC had the favorites, but I still have faith in Wings. I mean, they had excellent composure to come back and take game one, so I believe they can do the same for game two. But a bit more into the draft, Doom and Dazzle pick up this time, so. Okay, I mean, Wings decide they're not going to give that away. Slada and Tuskar, always fun to watch, just snowball into the Slithering Crush. CDEC Youth looks like they're just banning out tons of mid laners for now. Wings Gaming, well, it's not like, you know, the mid laner is that restricted when it comes to mid heroes. He's quite versatile as well, almost the same as Inflame. So it's really interesting to watch these two mid players show off every single time. But a bit more into the bans, Bane, it's understandable why you want to take that out. He's had a huge impact, especially in the first 3 minutes of each game. Undying in PL, I guess you just don't want to play against PL just for the late game. Do you want to end it fast?
Yeah. So essentially, the way I'm looking at it is Shadowfiend and Ancient Apparition were the first picks for the Wings in their first phase draft when they were on the Dire. We're seeing CDEC Youth ban those two heroes out, forcing the Wings to actually take the two picks that CDEC Youth had in game one. They had the Doom Dazzle opener, so now we're seeing Slaughter Tusk kind of be that dual lane that has some value in this position, but honestly, I feel like Dazzle still beats Slaughter Tusk if you have a good damage-dealing safe laner. So Dazzle, Wyvern, they're going to be able to respond with the Arctic Burn, probably a Cold Embrace, high priority at level 2, and then the Shadow Wave Bomb. As long as you don't kill somebody within the initial chain of stuns, which is unlikely, that will be plenty of opportunity for like a Juggernaut to bite back, and I think that that's probably going to be the pick here. We've already got the Gyrocopter banned out along with the Viper, so you definitely want to hear like Jug on your side. But we're going to be seeing actually Queen of Pain picked up, and that's going to be most likely Inflames hero on the mid.
Tuskar!
Okay, that's one too. That definitely is a hero that bites back, and the Wings are looking to try to cheese their way through the 2-0.
I mean, we've been waiting for this combo. I mean, it's always been banned out, and Wings Gaming, I mean, they let it slip past, and I think CDEC, they're going to have to adjust the draft a bit more. I don't even know how they're going to cope against this. I mean, Shred of Pure Damage is okay. I don't know. This is really, really cheese.
Yeah, I think they have to find a way to stop the Grave. I think if they are able to silence the Dazzle or something along those lines, then they're fine already. They've got negative armor out of Slardar and Razor, Burst Physical out of Tusk, Burst Pure out of Queen of Pain. They have plenty of ways to kill the Huskar, but they have to stop the Shallow Grave. That's the most important thing here. And I think that any kind of silence, any kind of controlling support to take Dazzle out of the equation is going to give them the path to killing Huskar. But of course, Cold Embrace and the Shallow Grave are both backing this Huskar up, so it's not necessarily one or the other, though the Grave is by and large the most important. Obviously, Armlet also has multiple instances of damage that would punish it, so Eye of the Storm is pretty good. Shadow Strike's probably not great. But anyways, now we got the final bans here. Ancient Apparition doesn't seem probable, but actually that was banned out in phase one. So what are we actually looking at here? Like Disruptor, yeah, that's the silencing hero I was gonna think of, since Night Stalker isn't very viable with the Tusk Slaughter already picked. Could they go for an actual silencer like Nortrum?
Unlikely. They already have the Razor picked up if the Queen of Pain. So if anything, they would go for something with a bit more control, something like, I mean, not an Earthshaker, thinking of range supports. This is tough. Disruptor was probably, it was actually a really good option. keep up the light, but that's so unlikely.
Why do you say keeper?
For the mana drain and the mana leak. If you can use it on the Huskar while he's, you know, charging all around him and he's in mid jump, he pretty much gets a free stun. I would say it synergizes pretty well with the Razor Static Link, just because you can run, and if you do, you're just going to get stunned. And the stun from the mana leak is actually quite significant. It's something which pubs, I feel like players have yet to utilize. Sometimes it works out, and at the same time with the Blinding Light, it's going to help a lot against the Huskar.
Alright, so Wings Gaming going into their fifth pick here, already facing an Invoker ban, as well as, of course, Disruptor. Taken off the table by themselves. But they're just looking to round out their lineup with a strong mid. TA is still fine here, I'm sure. What else are we looking at? There's nothing really that stands out as like a great pick. There's plenty of perfectly fine normal picks here, but I mean, overall, you just want somebody that gets involved early so that you can kind of build momentum. Yeah.
I just thought of one hero which could be really cheese for Wings. Draw Ranger.
Oh, why not? Yeah.
Or even Avenge. Even Avenge would be fine this game, just with a negative armor. I mean, both these heroes go well with the Huskar. I mean, preferably Drow for the aura, because that would be super cheese. It goes well with the Dazzle and the Winter Wyvern as well. Off lane. CDC, sorry, the last pick. One more support. Thinking in a hero pool. Besides Lion Trian Protector, that'd be really weird. The Shrek.
Interesting. So, Dire team pick. Gonna be able to push down towers a little bit more rapidly and build that snowball up. Obviously, great response to a Tusk snowball play since you got the multiple man split Earth. You don't really want to Lightning Storm the Razor since you're slowing each other equal amounts, but obviously, it's still a great amount of nuke damage coming out. And it's just going to be hard for a Sea Deck to really withstand that punishment. If you get like Splinter Blast and Lightning Storm on everybody in a fight, that's half their health gone and Huskar does the rest. So overall, I think it's a pretty strong pick. I'm curious how much he prioritizes Diabolic Edict, if at all, this game.
That would probably be the case. And I think it's just for a nice bit of stun and bit of magic damage. So if the Queen of Pain blinks in, I'm sure I can catch that. And probably just kite around the Slaughter a bit more. It's always good. And okay, I think that's pretty much about it. Wings are just really, really very cheese. They want to end this very fast. They definitely don't want to drag against late game and Witch Doctor. Yep. Oh yeah, we actually left him out.
Yeah, pretty solid pickup. I mean, it doesn't have great control over the Dazzle. Really just the Death Ward is what you're looking for there. And still has a decent chance of getting that off. Wyvern's definitely not going to be caring if he Winter's Curse is near a Death Ward or not. So it's more so the less stun. The Doom has two stuns, in a way, with the Doom and the level death. And that's pretty much what you're looking at, until Dazzle gets maxed out, which is going to take a long time. So, mostly just the Doom and the Lush to control the Witch Doctor means that Witch Doctor's Death Ward is probable, but as far as the value of his cask and his restoration, we'll have to see.
The caskets can do pretty okay, I guess. It should be okay, since you would usually expect your Dazzle to be always around the Huskar, but I don't think the Witch Doctors have a pretty good game. He's probably going to get zoned out very easily by heroes like the Lushrak, who can just run him down. Oh, I like this cosmetic set.
Yeah, very interesting cosmetic set, Lushrak. You can go ahead and introduce the teams. I'm going to do a quick reconnect to try to nip Perfect World thing in the bud pretty early.
On the Radiant side, for Wings, we have Innocence playing on the Dazzle. We will have Shadow Big, whatever, Big Donger on the Huskar. We will have the Jumping Daggers on the Lushrak. Ice playing on the Winter Wyvern. And the offlane, we will have Bien playing on the Doom. For the Dire side, 5-man smoked up currently CDC Youth Demons on the Tuskar, June on the Slaughter. We have Ame on the Queen of Pain, and Flame on the Razor mid. It's going to be Icy on the Witch Doctor. And the 5-man smoke movement doesn't yield any fruit, so. Okay, looks like Wings, they're just going to hit to the top out of the river. So it's going to be just 5 per team getting the bounty each.
So pretty nothing inconsequential. Much. Any good wards coming out?
Not really. They do get a nice observer ward, which blocks the camp. It's south of the easy camp. But otherwise, you just have a lane ward. Not really a lane ward. It's just like your normal standard ward. Placed just at the very tip. Not your rune ward, though.
So, at this point, laning configuration, how is the Huskar fitting into all that? Is it definitely the safe lane core?
Actually, it's too early to tell yet. Yeah. Oh, actually, wait. He's going to offlane.
Okay.
Yeah, it's gonna be the Huskar in the offlane with the Dazzle. So they're gonna pressure this Slada very, very hard. Ice, ice, going mid with the Lashrak, and it's going to be the Doom who goes into the safe lane.
All right, very interesting. So, just kind of going for kind of this aggressive duo that can pretty much deal with anything. Unfortunately, Dazzle only has one Tango, so he's gonna have to stay back. But Huskar himself can go very active, very aggressive with the potential for the Shadow Wave healed. The Slaughter can't really man up on it. We're actually going to see mid here the death of the Queen of Pain. A nice little flank coming out there, and she's going to go down to the Wyvern and the Leshrac together. Yeah, good use of the Arctic Burn, but she's just going to make her way right back to the mid lane with the TP.
Mm-hmm. And nope. Okay, Wings is going to get an extra bit of regeneration thanks to the Tango and the Ward. I mean, not exactly having a good time against the Leshrac. We haven't seen these kind of matchups in quite a while, ever since Leshrac got nerfed quite huge for the patch. Demons gonna find Jungling Doom, who's still looking for a creep. He's actually gonna find the Toughness Aura. Surprisingly, he's not even going to go into the lane against Inflame because he just can't. It's more efficient to just jungle. So Inflame is actually gonna have a free lane here at the bottom.
Yeah, so that should be pretty interesting. No confrontation, no contest lane for the Razor means he's going to get a lot of farm early. I'm assuming a mechanism will arise out of that. Very important against a Huskar to be able to sustain yourself. But in the meantime, Demons has taken half of this Doom's HP, and it's still pretty inefficient overall. Like, he's taken so long to kill off a simple Satyr camp, and he doesn't have a stout shield to block their damage. So Demons taking half that experience while also being able to lurk and have a flanking position against mid, it makes things very frustrating for Beyond. He will stack a couple times. Ideally, he gets a Wild Wing tornado out pretty soon, but if you look at it, he actually, at level 1, didn't even have the mana for the spell, so it's a very mana-intensive thing, but it looks like he will be able to clear out this triple stack now.
Alright. Yeah. That's actually pretty efficient. And a bit of good luck as well. So he's actually... Wait, is this going to be enough for level 3? I think it should be. Demon's actually going to
clear
off
this. Depends
on where
the Tusk is, yeah. Okay. But yeah, he'll definitely get to level 3 as Demon's is too far away.
Alright, pretty good usage. And he has Clarity. So after this, he can actually hit back to the lane. And top lane, I think Ice Ice, the Huskar, they want to pressure this a bit more. But no, June's going to have a decent time. At least he doesn't have to worry so much about sustainability thanks to the Ice. Like the Icy Spirit Doctor for Food Restoration. But he will find a ping on Demons.
And now we're gonna see this 3v2 break out. They isolate Icy. Even if he goes to get help from an ally, he's just gonna be the Splinter Blast chained up against him. But the damage over time ticks through, and that is the death of the Witch Doctor, making a 2-0 lead for Wings early on.
Have a decent head start. Not what you want out of the Huskar. So the best Inflame can do is just get the maximum, you know, amount of farm you can out of this bottom lane. Doom as well, same thing. He's probably just going to keep on stacking using the Wildling Ripper to just farm up the camps. That's all he can pretty much do at this point. Mm-hmm. Demons has just been leeching EXP. He's actually almost level 2. It's not bad.
Yeah, but still, I mean, not, there's a big difference between almost level 2 and level 2, but he does finally get it. So he has both Ice Shards and the Snowball here. And Doom ends up just picking up the Dark Troll Summoner and starting to build up his skeleton army to jungle in that capacity. There's a lot of ways that Doom can use the creeps to jungle efficiently there, but doing a decent job while, of course, giving Razor still a free lane. 26 and 14 on the Razor, only 17 and 15 on the Bossman. We're going to see a top rune exchange that June is going down very quickly. And it looks like he will fall to the Dazzle again. So Dazzle's actually gotten 2 kills to his name, already building himself up boots and then some. And of course they get the rune for the Lush.
Surprising why they keep the Dazzle keeps getting on these last hits, but it's okay I guess. Huskar's farm has been uncontested. But his last hits, he's actually at 2017 compared to the Inflame who's at 3016. He has a complete free lane, and it doesn't seem like Wings are, you know, concerned at all about this.
Yep, just going to be getting 100% experience. He's actually like a full 100 experience per minute above the Leshrac. So he's actually just, the fact that there's been so many denies coming out from the Queen of Pain, she's actually denied 10 creeps here. It just gives a C-Deck a nice little level advantage. they're going to be able to exploit, as this Razor just has so much more to work with. Because early skilling for Razor can be a little bit tricky. Obviously, like, for the lane, you want the Static Link, but then for the fights, you want the Plasma Field. And now he kind of just only has to put 2 points in the Link, and he can focus on the fight build from this point forward, and maybe the Eye of the Storm coming into play soon.
The value point in the Unstable Current would, be better, especially if he's going to fight the Huskar. I think his logic right now is, I mean, in team fights, by maxing the Plasma Field, by doing more damage to the Winter Wyvern and Dazzle, it could be better if he gets it off, and he doesn't need the maximum Static Link, he just needs to get enough damage out of the Huskar, who does not have a lot of base damage at all, and he usually doesn't go for damage items. And bottom lane, oh, looks like we finally might see some contest in Flame. He's gonna get burned down by Ice Ice, he's gonna just TP out, no stuns, and alright, he gets away.
Yeah, that's one drawback of the lineup. As I mentioned before, Lesh and Doom are the number one stunners here, and that's just going to be a limiting factor for interrupting any kinds of channels, including TPs. Tusk will connect with his stun, followed up by the Slaughter, the classic combo, but with the Shallow Grave, Innocent's not only fine, but looking to turn things around a little bit here, and June will drop down to half HP before backing off. So, in the end, the Wyvern is having to rotate a lot, but in the end, it's still going to be stabilizing their lanes and giving them the kill advantage.
This is more a big win for the supports, just because of the economy distribution right now for Wings. They are actually pulling ahead quite consistently over the past few minutes. It doesn't look like there are any stacks for, like, you know, the Queen of Pain to flash farm in the jungle. She's just doing her best, but Lashrak has been doing pretty well to hold her there. Rotations in sight, I doubt, so at least till level 8.
Yeah, and normally I would be concerned a little bit about the Doom being only level 4 at this point, but you look at the Slaughter and he's no better off. He's been kind of forced into different positions on the map. He's not been able to get too much done on the top lane. So just all in all, it feels like it's a pretty even game in the early game, which just means it's going to be harder and harder for C-Deck as we go into the mid game where this Huskar starts dominating. We are going to see Ice Shards block things off, but it looks like Razor going for another TP, and this one will succeed as well. Doesn't go all the way back to Fountain though, going to have to get healed up. Is he actually going to be going down? No, the Burning Spear is ticking him low. Okay, very close call, but Inflame will survive. Interesting decision to go for the tower TP instead of the fountain, but they do narrowly avoid death, which obviously is a really big deal since the Razor is such a key part of C-Deck's game plan right now.
26 HP, that was clutch. Well, he probably figured that, hey, I have a salve, why not, you know, I might have a chance to use it, and there's a Witch Doctor there to keep me alive anyways. But if not for the Witch Doctor, he definitely would have died.
Unless you go for some crazy snowball play just to dismiss a couple of dot ticks, but no, that was pretty intense. Even still, we've got ourselves a Huskar approaching an armlet very rapidly. You know, he's not doing as well as the Razor or the Lesh, but he's doing pretty well overall, and he's going to have a pretty well-timed set of items. Up top, June is going to be getting some damage onto the Tier 1 tower, but not much. I think these towers will overall stand for a long time. There's not many great pushers on either side at this stage of the game.
Okay, I'm just looking at this Lashrak. I'm trying to monitor his farm rate. Yeah, there's no Diabolic Edict inside. It's basically just your usual Lightning Storm into the Split Earth. That's it. And yeah, he's actually level 8, has an advantage over the Queen of Pain. While Winter Wyvern actually has a whole lane to herself, it's only the Slaughter here. Oh. So he's actually a huge win.
They block off the western route for Beyond, but they're just going to be able to nuke him down. Shallow Grave got to come out to help him out. And I think the Scorched Earth will mitigate the Shadow Strike's effectiveness. Inflame, though, very strong, just on the front line here with the Magic Wand treads. And he's actually going to be able to go for one more Plasma Field. Demons, very low on HP, goes for one more Ice Shard, survives. And now the Queen of Pain goes in deep. Inflame gives himself a double kill, killing off the Wyvern, and sends the other two just running as far as they can, but Shadow might just be able to 1v3 in this position. Inflame gonna be taking a lot of damage just from the Burning Spears here. Doesn't have any more right-click damage, but it looks like he will fall just to the dots, and that is gonna be that. Lashrak, no more spells left to cast. Ame will blink away. So, 4-2 now. At least getting a couple points on the board there, but Huskar still positive with 1-0-1.
That was the most awkward kill I've seen in a while. He had negative 120 damage, but he still got a kill because of the DOT. I don't know, man. I gotta admit, because I'm a horrible Huskar player, that's why I'm not a fan of the hero, but still, it's always interesting to watch.
Yeah, and of course, he definitely has a lot more potential now that he has the armlet here. Probably wants to avoid the static link more than the situation that just arose, but it's definitely going to be him just putting out more and more damage, and of course, living really well, effectively at low HP. And interestingly enough, he doesn't have to really prioritize Berserker's Blood too heavily because of how little magic damage there is coming in from C-Deck. Unless the Witch Doctor went for a Maledict, which obviously he wouldn't against a Huskar. Berserker's Blood isn't really that valuable. The attack speed's great, but only scales from 14 to 20, so it's really the magic resistance that you usually look for, and you get some value from Vitality.
Amp damage is up, you get stunned, yep, and one lucky bash as well, so Jun's gonna get himself a nice kill, and gets closer and closer to his Blink Dagger. Nice rotation in from Ami.
So, early net worth, we're seeing the Leshrac and the Huskar top things off. Three cores trailing just behind that, and the Doom not far behind either, though. Of course, the fact that he is a devouring Doom, and is even behind the Slaughter net worth, is kind of a loss, but not a significant one. They're going to go in hard onto Inflame. They aren't going to be able to stun him unless they go for the Doom, and yeah, that's either range or hesitation means they won't get that kill.
Bit unfortunate, but still, yeah, they've actually baited many TPs out from Inflame this game. I think that was his third or fourth time TPing back to base. Wings going. Wait, is Leshrac going for a Yules? Looks like a Yules. I mean, he has a Sage Mask. It could be a Soaring as well into like a Bloodstone. And here we're gonna see four heroes from Wings gonna try and push this bottom T1. It doesn't matter that Shadow is taking damage. He has the Armlet and he has a Dazzle, so no fear.
Not at all, but we're going to be seeing maybe an opportunity for C-Deck Search War with this Eye of the Storm. They would have to have the Slaughter rotate, though, and they really just want Jun to passively farm for another 60 seconds. That'll get him to his Blink Dagger, and then the rotation can come through in earnest. But until he gets that Blink, you really don't want to do much. And we're actually seeing Dazzle rotate up. Can they actually get another hero up here? Yeah, they're going for the Huskar Dazzle Smoke play. They want to punish the Slaughter, delay his Blink, but it looks like it's come out too quickly. He should be able to buy it even when they make the jump.
Yeah, it's definitely too late already. He can buy it, but... Oh, unless he doesn't go to the side shop right now.
We'll see. Oh, he's going to have to buy it from the regular shop. Buy it quick. There it is. Jun will have it. And a smoke. He's like, I know I'm going down. Or it looks like it. The Voodoo Restoration again saving
him. He's
not
going
to die! Jeez.
He gets away on 27 HP thanks to the Witch Doctor's Voodoo Restoration in the nick of time.
It's going to help out a lot more and more this game, just dealing with the overtime effects that we're seeing a lot more from the Wings. Razor's just looking for an opportunity here, obviously a free kill on the Wyvern if he walks out on the lane, but it looks like he's playing very passive and, of course, can set up a Winter's Curse rotation.
I mean, this can actually potentially be one of those games where the Witch Doctor skills in such a way where he completely ignores the Maledict and he just maxes out this Paralyzing Curse, Restoration, and Death Ward, and the rest of it goes into stat points. You know, over here, I think they're going for a stun. There we go, nice two-man crush. Amplify damage comes out. And actually, wait, Huskar is still alive. Sonic Wave is only going to land on the track. He's going to fall. And here comes the Static Link. Shadow's still alive. Here comes the Grave. He's going to try and do it as much as he can, but he's still stunned up. He's just going to die in the back. And Wings. Lose three, well, CDEC have no casualties at all. Radiance and Doom gets a tower deny.
So the deny is kind of nice, but that was a great movement there, unveiling the Blink Dagger, Radiance saying, haha, got it first. And the fact that he bought the Blink Dagger before he died is just so Radiance important. Obviously, not too difficult, he had some time, but. And actually, he didn't die, did he? So, no matter the case, Jun, he gets the Blink, uses it to great effect. They find themselves in a great position to start finding kills, and they can do that every time Sonic Wave's up, and that's going to be in not too long, 90 more seconds.
You can only imagine how frustrated Wings are. They're probably thinking to themselves, we could have delayed that Blink Dagger, but now, no. They're just going to have to, you know, keep moving forward and hope for the best, because, yeah, CDEC, this lineup is really built counter Huskar. Pure damage, stealing damage, amplified damage, and you know, you've got the physical damage of the Death Ward and the Tuskar to Warrior's Punch to kite him around with the Sigil. This draft is really just the anti-Huskar draft.
Yep, and now with the Orchid approaching for the Queen of Pain. Oh no, she goes Sages into Point Booster, so we're just gonna see the Axe, which is great. The cooldown and the pure damage is very important against Huskar, but no Orchid means the Dazzle might still get that Grave off. Going in here, they do miss the crush, but still snowballing right over past the ice shards, and that leaves Shadow kind of to do his own thing here in the lane itself. On the eastern flank, we see the Doom coming out onto Ame, but a crush comes out on Beyond, and that damage is not going to be killing off the Queen of Pain. Instead, it's going to be Beyond running for his life. Scorched Earth gets him some distance, but it's not going to be enough to keep him alive unless that's Cold Embrace, and now the Winter's Curse does just enough, and that is going to be the death of both the Tusk and the Slardar, as now they still look to keep fighting. They only have three heroes here, but Inflame feels confident. They're going to try to fight it out with the Dazzle now dead. There is no Shallow Grave, but they only get the Huskar in exchange. That was just too ambitious. They didn't have enough heroes involved, so it's going to be a 2-for-1 on the tail end unless Ame can make it a third. And yeah, they do actually get that kill. So that's going to be a 2-for-2 in total, at least for that part of the exchange. Did you say
stop? I'm not sure what Ice was thinking there, but yeah, okay, that was actually really stupid and really smart, but okay. There we go, Queen of Pain gets a nice solo kill, getting closer and closer to the Aghanim Scepter. And Orchid is definitely not a good game, it's an item this game, purely because of the Huskar. They just want to cannon Huskar, you can see. And I'm surprised they even won that fight, despite not having the Static Link up. So, alright, next objective should be the top T1, so that they can start taking over the enemy jungle, get more map control. And they have some very nice wards, which actually spots out Roshan, just in case CDCV want to do that.
Yep, so they've got some good coverage here. Obviously the lane ward being very important in this kind of position. You see CDEC very frequently rallying from that position. I still think you might go Orchid after the Axe, but you definitely need the Axe first and foremost, just to make sure that your cooldowns aren't the limiting factor, because this team otherwise has like 60 second cooldowns at most, 80 for the Eye of the Storm, I guess, but overall, they have some very substantial potential to fight at repeat engagements, and they want to fight when the Winter's Curse is down, but that thing's coming back up in just 8 seconds, and with it, Wings are pressing forward. Pedal to the metal, they're going for the Tier 2 tower. It looks like that will be falling here. CDEC can't control it, so they're going to let it go. And it's actually Ice, like, it's a great opportunity for Winter's Curse, but they don't want to fight at the steps. They want to just dominate the map and look at Roshan. Once they get that Aegis, they're feeling very confident. Oh, but now that Huskar's TP'd away, it's going to be Beyond that gets isolated, and a cask will be going out against him. No bounces, but still the Death Ward. Oh, just outside of range means that Doom is actually going to be okay here. Nice Cold Embrace. The Static Link, though, is going to be a big deal. They have to kill off the Razor Knower. He's going to have way too much auto-attack damage, and they are able to focus him down sufficiently enough. He will tick down to the Doom. Beyond will be finished off next, but Demons going to be out of mana, now having to stick up and try to just delay it with the Snowball. It looks like he's going down. That's a 2-for-1. Again, a bad trade for CDEC. Are we actually going to be seeing this fast of a game going against CDEC? They just don't seem to be executing the way they need to in the fights. They always seem to be taking engagements past when they have the opportunity to strike, and now I would have to say that they are at a gigantic disadvantage in this game.
Yeah, it's when you think that you can counter the Huskar. I mean, execution is a completely different thing here. And yeah, why do they want to take this? I mean, they have double damage on the Huskar. This is still there for a while, but okay, not anymore. Yeah, that was just a bit too ambitious from the Witch Doctor and the Tuskar.
Yeah, I mean, the Huskar wasn't even a factor there. He had already TP'd across the map. It was just they really thought that they could just all jump in against Wings there, and even those four heroes still bring a lot to the table. And CDEC just couldn't focus the target down effectively enough, especially with so much behind the Doom. He got Cold Embraced, and this Cold Embrace actually is really good on the Doom in particular, because he has so much raw HP. This guy has 1360 health, and such an amazing strength pool, as well as a strength gain, and the drums. So what that means is the Cold Embrace level 2, healing, and now level 3, healing up 5% per second, is going to be giving him just all the health he needs to stay in the fight. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Okay, they're smoking it. I love this play, though. That is such a smart smoke movement, and they won't break, so they'll check inside the pit, and this is a great opportunity for CDEC to try to catch Wings off guard. Queen of Pain here. Oh, seen by the Observer Ward. They know about him. Can they kill him? Yes, they get the Winter's Curse and Chain Stun for the kill. Oh, it was such a smart idea. They get the wraparound, but they're going to have to, again, go in without the numbers advantage. They have lost so much here, and if they get a perfect death ward, maybe, but I really don't feel like this is a fight anymore. 4v5.
they need the Sonic Wave, they need the burst damage, but this is a very slow Roshan. Ice. No Winter's Curse, they can do this. The Grave is gonna keep him alive with the Cold Embrace. And actually, Inflame's gonna get hunted down by Shadow and the Lashrak. Huskar's gonna get a kill on the Razor. They have to back up, but the buyback's really used from the Queen of Pain. They have to commit it's all or nothing, and Ami is probably thinking about Aegis Steel.
They might be able to go with the Blink Crush here, just try to go in as quick as possible. They do get Vision inside the pit with the Ice Shards, but Tusk so low on HP. They're gonna go in hard, just two-man Blink in, they snatch the Aegis, they actually get the Roshan kill as well, and they Walrus Punch Shadow up in the air, but a two-man Split Earth goes against them. The Aegis will pop quickly, Blink cooling down. June and Icy will go on the run, and Ame will get the Blink away. So all in all, really good movement there from C-Deck to deny the golden experience of Roshan, to take the Aegis off the table, which otherwise would have meant most likely a tier 3s going down, and perhaps the Rax as well. So great play there, but obviously at the cost of more lives.
That was just really good play, and CDEC, they just managed to successfully prolong the game. Just because, you know, if Huskar had the Aegis, they definitely would have tried to push down the mid, or at least T2 down. So Wings, I don't know, but I feel that this game is slowly slipping out of control. It's going CDEC's way, just a bit.
Yeah, it's going to be, as we see the items progress, I think C-Deck are going to be feeling more and more confident going into it. I mean, Sardar is going to have that Force Staff soon. The mechanism for the Tusk, I think, is a really big deal, since the Razor didn't go for it. And, yeah, I mean, I gotta say I'm not too impressed by Leshrac's progression. Going for Yules into Aghanim Scepter. That, I mean, we've seen a lot of Leshrac over the past several months since he used to be the most popular hero, and yeah, Bloodstone got nerfed, but this is a kind of items that we never really saw on the hero.
Alright, I think they may find Inflame, yep, Poison suddenly comes down, and Static Link, actually, it's not gonna do much, but the Winter's Curse is gonna go in Demons, and goodbye. Tuskar's just gonna pay for it he's just gonna die right there, and I see also going to die. Maybe? Actually, no.
No, they don't have setup. Like, you see how they're using the Winter's Curse? It's like they're just trying to get a setup stun. They're using, like, a magic missile. This Winter's Curse is such a long cooldown, and they have to actually use it to set up the Lesh. So while they do get the Tusk kill, and it may set up the Tier 2, in the meantime, they don't even get that. This Winter's Curse, actually, I think, I'm not going to say it was a bad spell to cast there, because obviously they got their kill, but it means that they aren't that strong for the next 60 seconds.
They're probably just gonna wait and drag things out till the Huskar gets that halberd, and afterwards then they can fight. So at least, you know, it kinda negates the stolen damage taken on Inflame. This is what they can do. It's both of these drafts are actually just about, you know, delaying the fights. It's not so much about bursting anyone down. It's really about just who can drag the fight out the longest.
I mean, maybe if June and Ame get the right initiation they're looking for, they can just insta-gives support. They can easily kill the Dazzle or the Winter Wyvern down in the duration of a Slithering Crush, but only if they get the perfect jump. Otherwise, yeah, it does come down to really just who can get more done over the course of the fight, especially with that Razor. So, let's look at the damage per second of this Pulse Nova here. It goes from a 130 damage to 190, and the mana per second remains the same. So it's, I mean, obviously very cost efficient, but he's essentially just looking to be Pulse Novaing in the fight, self-yules himself to survive, and just kind of play it like the magical version counterpart of a Death Prophet. He's actually going to get caught by the Crush here, though, and they're just going to chain stun him to Oblivion with the Walrus Punch. Down he goes. And now Huskar coming in a little late. He's 1v4. Oh my gosh, Shadow, what have you done? He feels so confident in himself. He's diving in and he's dying in the process. What in the world?
I immediately regret my decision is what he's thinking. Oh god. Alright, so T2 it seems. And yeah, Wings. Oh, you find Bien at the side. Radiant's just gonna back off. Ice.
Well, they still have vision on him. They're gonna go for the Blink Crush over the hill, it looks like. They've got the Ice Shard to isolate, but now they're afraid of the Winter's Curse. The Wyvern has arrived, and they sound the alarm bells of retreat. They've got their mechanism, they're just happy with that. They really didn't need more out of that exchange. Just killing Lesh and Huskar is plenty, since again those two. Well, I was going to say they're the top two in net worth on the Radiant side, but Bjorn has slowly crept up there after that Huskar's last death.
Alright, yeah, I think Wings needs to... they probably had a bit of miscommunication. I mean, besides the Winter's Curse, there was only like, what, 10 seconds left on both the respawn timers of Wings, the Huskar and the Lushrak. And now they're going to get like one smoke coming out, maybe find June. They don't have detection though. But they may find demons. It's a nice consolation prize. He's going to take out the sentry maybe? Actually no, he's just going to walk away, but they do see him.
Yep, but still able to keep his distance it looks like, and I think Wings will have to give the goat as long as they don't find the slaughter here. Oh, close call! Actually, almost gets in range for the life break. That would have been huge, but no, he'll slip through without having to TP away. Whatever minor victory that may be. Icy split pushing top, gets himself some experience, and are they going to sack the bottom tier too? I think they might need to. It's very hard to rally into this position, especially against a Wyvern. Tower is under attack.
Radiant structures are fortified. This is just pretty sick. Top tower that was so close.
Alright, so they're going to go ahead, lose their tier 2 bottom, try to force a tier 2 top, but we already have some TPs going in, and the static link has completely failed. They're going to focus down the Leshrac, though. He doesn't have the Yules to keep himself alive. Aghanims are not. It's going to be a shallow grave that allows him to keep fighting. With the Winter's Curse, he's doing massive damage, and he will survive thanks to his supports. Wow. This is why he can go for this kind of glass cannon build, the Ag's Yules. It's because he relies on his supports, the Dazzle and the Wyvern, just doing everything they need to keep him alive. Mini stun not going to come out from beyond, so the Witch Doctor will escape, but even still, they defend their tier 2 top, and they get, of course, a tremendous kill in the Razor.
Giving away the Winter Wyvern and the Dazzle to accompany a Huskar, this three heroes in the same draft is just...
Yeah, but it's not even just the Huskar. Like, the Huskar hasn't done anything for the past 10 minutes. It really comes down to just the Wyvern and the Dazzle with any of their heroes. They've got the Doom with his raw HP pool, the Cold Embrace. The Leshrac can still Pulse Nova while he's caught in the Cold Embrace. And yeah, of course, the Shallow Grave and the Cold Embrace from the Huskar, who is nigh immortal with those effects. It's just amazing.
I mean, I actually completely agree with you. I mean, it just feels like maybe they pick the Huskar, make you build around it, but actually the real problem is the Leshrac, so... Shadow's just there to soak damage, that's pretty much it. Just like that meat shield in front. Oh, Icy comes up from the trees, looks like they want to fight here. Ami, oh, nice. Crush catches him, amplified damage, and the death ward to follow. But we jump. Actually, no, they're just going to TP out right now. Everyone backs off. Oh, but no.
Can't cancel, it's just a doom.
Alright, but that's probably the best case scenario, you know, minimal casualties.
So, yeah, I mean, at this point, Wings do disengage freely, and they'll probably have a good position for, like, Roshan, which is going to be spawning soon. But, I mean, there have been a lot of kills going to C-Deck that weren't supposed to happen. We've got Blink, Yules, Axe on the Leshrac. But, yeah, the bottom line is really, like, the support backline. If they can get, a kill on the Dazzle or the Wyvern before they get their spells off, the fight is already over because Wings, all three cores of Wings, are relying so heavily on their backbone support. But here we see it's so difficult to find that opening, and especially fighting in choke points here. They're smoking just before Roche is going to spawn. And Slaughter actually does break. Radiant Observer Ward also on the high ground here, so they do scout out a lot of these heroes on the backline.
So just a wasted smoke from CDEC. I mean, this game is really, really close. It's so even right now that it could go either way. There's no clear winner yet in this game.
I think that C-Deck have to out-execute, though. I feel like Wings have the easier path to victory here, so while the game is even in terms of the metrics and the resources and such, I feel like the current game plan of Wings is very simple, and it does not... You don't have to outplay your opponent every fight just to make it work. But C-Deck definitely have the ability to pull forward if they just find their openings. Smokes right now, it looks like completely out of stock. Yeah, Dire do not have any smokes right now, which probably is their biggest weakness. And we're actually just going to see a quick jump on Inflame. They'll force that from forward with the Winter's Curse. Doom as well, man! That's a lot of hate for a Razor, but if it gets them Roshan, then it's worth it. For now, though, they're actually pushing on the tier 3.
You want to bait buyback, but there's no buyback in the Razor, so from this, they can pretty much guess, and yeah. If they survive this, they can actually just take this tower.
Yeah, they don't have ultis to back this up, but they still have that Grave. They'll just keep the Dazzle as far back as possible, and they'll just keep healing the Cheskar. Kill the Brace against the Death Ward, doesn't care at all, and they have negated a lot of what Sita can bring against the Huskar. Now snowballing out, he's got the Grave, no! The Sonic Wave comes out, the Walrus Punch at just the right time, Dazzle can't save him in time, and a beautiful Four Staff Crush from June in conjunction with Demon's Ice Shards. They'll knock down the Dazzle, ice with them, and take Roshan for themselves, and that's why I was so surprised they didn't just go for the pit.
That was the worst case scenario for Wings, and CDEC, they have to take this Roshan now and just keep delaying the game, because the late game they definitely win.
Just the Dazzle was, I mean, Huskar was confident in his Dazzle, and the Dazzle was probably confident in himself, but in the end, just it's milliseconds of when that Shallow Grave comes out to when suddenly that hero loses a third of their health to Ame's Burst. It's just, you want to try to maximize the effectiveness of Shallow Grave by graving them when they're about to die, but if you don't get it a little bit early, then a hero like Winnipane will just pull the rug out from under you.
Man, I don't even know how they lost that, and that was without the Razor. So, you know, if CDEC just keep doing this, they can actually win. Right now, the gold graph is just dead even. It's actually at zero. EXP in favor of CDEC, but who cares about EXP at this point? I mean, everyone's getting their core items up, and it's an Aegis and a Razor now, so they decide to jump on Inflame again. Looks like Wings probably have no choice but to just, you know, kick back and just farm a bit more. So hopefully Shadow can get closer to a Helm of Dominator and possibly into a Satanic.
Yeah, I just feel like when the ultimates are on cooldown, obviously meaning the Doom and the Wyvern ultimates, the big two, when those are on cooldown, they are so dependent on a Shallow Grave. If Dazzle just messes his window, just even slightly, the fight's done. It's so fragile if they don't have those ultimates. With those ultimates to fall back on, they have an advantage on every engagement, but the way they doubled them up on the Razor there, obviously lost in the subsequent fight.
Okay, I mean, for itemization for Inflame, what do you think? Do you go for, like, the Aghanim Scepter, or would you go for, like, an AC into a Shiva's or something like that?
He's looking at Manta Style, and I can't say I disagree. It's not the best item on Razor, because this hero, like, his stats are actually pretty weak, so his illusions aren't strong. But if you just pop that off early in the fight, you're putting out some good hits. It's good for split pushing as well. Like, you can just throw him out on the lane and then back off, and you're going to get some income as you keep the creeps away from your base. Since Wings only have, like, one or two heroes to wave clear, the Lesh, the Wyvern, really.
And I guess at the same time, you can kind of confuse the Doom.
Sure, yeah, break animations or anything like that would be great if you can find that invulnerability frame timing. That's very important, too, but obviously harder to pull off. Other than that, they've got their BKBs up on everybody. Aghanim Scepter soon for Witch Doctor. Guardian Grease for the Tusk if he doesn't go for Blink first. All that seems pretty clear cut, but yeah, Razor AC I think might be a little better, but obviously you've got the Slaughter who could build that up too. So there's a lot of different ways of Inflame could approach this one.
What about the Doom? I mean, okay, he's getting closer to a Shiva, so is this this is probably going to be Shiva's guard, so that the AC can come out on Shadow, if necessary.
Slardar, this was a bit of a mistake, but he four staffs away, maybe making up for it. The Yule's combo doesn't work the way they intended to, and can they get the stun in the trees? No.
Oh, career.
Just hanging around, trying to scout things out. Does pick up the Shiva's components, so that's going to be in Beyond's hands pretty soon.
Oh, this game is really, really intense. Both these teams. It seems like we have a really good understanding of each other. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, and I mean, Tuskar probably will be making his way towards Guardian Greaves, or maybe a Blink. Witch Doctor. Oh, he actually has the Aghanim Scepter, so next item could be a BKB, or is it a Glimmer Cape?
I don't know if he's going to be able to afford another item. Like, this game seems to be like the next 10 minutes we'll decide it. Maybe Glimmer Cape because it's just cheaper. But a BKB seems ambitious from him. Unless, I mean, there's not even that much comeback gold on the table. The graph's dead even, man. This is just so intense. Dazzle does get himself a Solar Crest. That's pretty huge. Man, this is... There's just so much that could possibly change the game right now. But it is going to be SMY from Inflame, which just gives him the ability to maybe run away from the Doom. When you have the Unstable Current maxed out and an SNY, you're approaching maximum Radiant's movement speed, and that allows you to kite away from big spells being cast upon you, like that Doom.
This is just one of the good things about these kind of games. I mean, it may seem pretty slow, but that's just how intense it is, because it's just so unpredictable at the same time. Shiva's Guard actually going to catch him just at the very end. He's going to go for level death, and yeah, they're just going to force them back, but it looks like CDEC refused to back off. They're looking for an opening, just biding the time. Amplify, oh, the shards actually sort of traps them out.
But they don't have a path to the Dazzle, that's the key here. Like, they have to fight through the Wyvern to get to the Dazzle, and the Dazzle is the hero that saves, pretty much negates any real initiation. So even if Bjorn goes down low, he's gonna be graved, and then he's gonna be cold embraced after the grave. It's just so hard to actually find their first pick in the fight. Oh, I see. This is huge. Oh. If they find the Witch Doctor or if they don't, he's either got an amazing flank, or he's got a death threat sentence. He's just going to TP at them. And that's very wise of him. They're full disengage from CDEC Youth.
This bottom part of the map, it's a really, really scary choke point. So that's why you don't want to be... You know, that's why CDEC just backed off. That was the smart decision to do. Wings, they're really confident. They're just like, all right, come on. Just like that, you know, the cowboy standoff. Who goes first? But CDEC, they know that, you know, that's the worst part of the play of the map to fight, so they just choose to back off and hopefully find a bit more items. I mean, Ame, probably an Assault Curse on his part as well. That could help. I mean, it looks like there's so much armor going around both teams. Oh, another smoke. But they're not gonna find anybody. Oh, they're just dodging each other. This is really awkward.
Yeah. We're gonna see if this might break on demons. He doesn't have a blink dagger and he wouldn't be able to use it anyways. He's gonna be crushed. Oh, he
blinked into the stun! No!
He will be doomed. He will be a winner's curse, but they're happy to pick up that kill. I think this is gonna be the buyback of the Queen of Pain.
That was so unlucky. He just blinked in immediately, thinking he would get Sonic Wave off of something. He just died. That was so bad. And right now, yeah, it looks like Wings will get to force out a buyback from the Queen of Pain at least.
I mean, that was just a gut reaction, man. He just like, I'm going in, I have to do something, and he didn't pop his BKB, so he just gets clobbered. Now he has to buy back. They're going to go with the jump onto Huskar here, but they really want the Dazzle. Oh, but don't come for the Wyvern. There's BKBs everywhere. The Wyvern won't get a good Winter's Curse. Of course, he doesn't have it. He's just trying to Splinter Blast, just trying to keep people alive, but the Huskar is going to get focused. Nice stun coming out from the last track onto two. Ame and June in some trouble, but Ame blinks into the tree line and bides this 5 second duration. Can he get back safely? This would be a dieback if he cannot, but Doom Shiva's cooling down. They're not going to bother hunting in the trees. They're going for the high ground. They're going for the racks. A Wyvern dies to the back line to the Sonic Wave, and the June actually force-staffing away. Going to be dropping down. No buyback available. It's going to come down to Demons here, taking a lot of damage. Looks like he'll tick down, and now there were three. Oh, Balorax being focused down, Queen of Pain's Sonic Wave in 20 seconds, Death Ward on cooldown. What can they do to save their barracks? It looks like that lane is gone.
This Dazzle is pretty much the main reason why CDEC can't win any of these fights, because he's just positioning himself so well, just hiding all the way at the back. He's always at the back, and CDEC just don't have a way to sprint through. I mean, yeah, you have your sprint from the Slaughter, but there's just so much... Like, such really strong frontline heroes, like, you know, your Doom and the Lushrak and Huskar, which you just cannot ignore. So, just really, really well played from the Dazzle to position himself in great spots. So, right now, I think CDEC, I don't really have a solution for this, but I can only say the game just got way harder for them.
Absolutely. I mean, the Lush is going to have an Octarine Core off of that. Looks like he's buying it from the Secret Shop as soon as it's safe to do so. And at that point, he's just going to be so huge and so difficult to deal with. He'll have his own way of healing himself back up and just sustaining throughout the fights. Of course, that Lightning Storm cooldown at only 3 seconds is definitely not something you want to ignore either. It's just so, so powerful.
They're just so crazy right now. I mean, Octarine Core. Maybe next item could be a Hex. Maybe even just casual Bloodstone. I'm surprised that Lushrak hasn't gone for a Bloodstone at all. And with one more smoke here, if they get lucky again, this would definitely be a second lane of Rax. mean, Shadow is just here at the Alpha Wolf, standing the front lines, and CDEZ, they're smart enough not to take the bait.
Ame just needs a little bit more farm. He's actually going for Lotus Orb here, and I love that pickup against this team, but it looks like it's going to come out too late. This final fight might be upon us before he gets a chance. The only hero with this buyback in this fight is going to be a Huskar. There's a decent chance Leshrac gets enough gold for it, just one kill away, but otherwise, this is a confrontation that will really be pretty much life and death for each individual hero, but it looks like they won't force it for now. Just trying to get better map control with the gem.
Something tells me Wings, they're not going to try pushing a mid because Roshan's up in a minute and a half, so...
It's a long spawn, isn't it? Yeah.
I mean, it's Chinese Dota. They're never going to take the dangerous option. They're always going to take the safe, calculated option.
Yeah. I mean, especially in this kind of situation, it's just such a key game here. If Wings can actually pull through here, and obviously they're at a 10,000 net worth and a full lane of Rax advantage, if they can close this one out, they're going to Minsk. This is the LAN qualifying decider for them.
I have to admit, where is Minsk again? I actually don't know where's Minsk. Is that... Do you know?
It's close to Russia, but I'd have to actually look at exactly what country, but I'm not going to go bother with that right now. And we're going to see the jump in, and Flame doomed up here could be the kill they need to win this one out, but they can't close distance. And that Sanjin Yasha pulling him away before the Leshrac knocks him out. That doom is wasted other than some damage keeping Razor back, and I don't think Wings are going to risk it.
I think his team was just a bit too far behind, otherwise that would have been like an amazing play. Alright, so there we go, checking for ward, not going to find any wards, and Winter Wyvern, it's either going to be a Lotus Orb or a Refresher Orb. And I think Refreshers would, I mean, both these items are still amazing anyways. Refresher would probably be the better choice here.
Alright, so Minsk is in Belarus, which is very close to Russia. At one point, of course, was part of the Soviet Union, and still speaks Russian, as far as I know. So, there you go. Today you learned.
Cool, thanks. Today I learned something new.
But there were so many visa issues with Chinese teams in Russia, they just wanted it somewhere slightly different. So it's still the same general geographical location, but a different governing body means easier visas. Okay, Inflame,
going in. Everybody!
Innocence is locked out! Dazzle all by himself doesn't get saved! They killed the Dazzle off at the beginning, but there's a massive winner's curse onto Inflame. Can they burn him down? He's just gonna PKB TP away, barely surviving with 100 HP! And they're gonna now focus down onto the Queen of Pain. She'll blink out. They actually haven't lost anyone yet. Finally, demons will fall. They can kill the Dazzle, but they'll...
Die back.
Oh, no, no, no. Disjointing the last hit. But there's the blink forward. Lash gets the kill. Razor lives with like 50 HP, but his allies fall in his absence, and that might be it. We see here three heroes dead without buyback for 30 seconds. There's no mana on the Leshrac, but one Edict will be enough to push through the barracks. And, it's really on these two. I mean, Tusk might be up in time to see Arax fall, but he's not going to be up alive to contest. It's going to be on Inflame right here, right now. He's clearing out creeps. They're ignoring the mid lane. They are going to let it fall. That's a 4 Arax disadvantage for C-Deck Youth. And they're just packing them back to the fountain. Dire's middle barracks
has fallen. Well, there's plenty more they can be packing, which is definitely not that bad to Minsk at this rate. And CDEC, but if finally needs one more kill, but the Cold Embrace is going to keep him alive, and Huskar, it is going to go straight for the Mega Creeps. There's no buyback, it's 40 seconds left on the co-op before Shufine comes up, and it's just a 4v5, they have to hold it. Rage is going to find himself the end side, but it's too late, Mega Creeps are here.
And this is C-Deck Youth about to be eliminated from Star Ladder I-League. They only needed two more games to get their ticket to the LAN Finals instead. They're going home empty-handed. They'll fight. They'll get some vengeance on the heroes, but it won't take away the hurt. The game is now 99% out of their hands. I mean, there's still a small chance. They're not going to say die at Mega Creeps. They're not going to GG when elimination is at hand. But at the same time, it seems like hope is lost.
You gotta hand it to them, fighting spirit. I mean, somewhere out there, Wings is probably, you know, someone in Wings is probably just trolling around saying, like, guys, this must be the 3-2-2 I've always dreamed about in my nightmares. And yeah, Mega Creeps, here we go. CDEC, Ame probably gonna build into those Mirror Nier kind of items, you know, creep clearing items, but Man, these creeps hit so much more. Yeah, they actually hurt more than the Witch Doctor. They're gonna go for Roshan.
Aegis and Cheese coming out for C-Deck as they're going to take this one down. That's obviously nice. Gives them more potential in the 5v5. But their real problem right now is dealing with the creep waves. They need to get Maelstroms, Mjolnirs, Vlads, anything they can do to just tank the creeps, help out their own creeps in fighting against the Mega Creeps, and also wave clear fast. We're actually going to see Beyond try to scout that out with Shivas. Throws a quick Doom on Inflame casually. Just not keep him out of the fight, and we're just gonna see a very nice Ice Shard TP, but a Split Earth at the maximum lip of it catches them both out. Oh, that was a great play, but just insufficient. That's gonna be two heroes down for the count. Cheeses, but down he goes. And that is now them playing left for Dota 2, going in and fighting under their tier 4s as the Mega Creep surge in.
GG CDEC Youth, and well played to Wings Gaming. The dream is not real anymore for the CDEC. But Wings, I mean, this Huskar pick. Yep, they're going in a bit more for Ame, nice crush. And this should be the GG push. I mean, the Mega Creeps are doing a lot of damage. Jun's trying to take out the Creep aggro, but yeah, it's just really messy. They will call the GG at last, and yeah.
An outstanding performance from Wings. I mean, their support line, the Dazzle and the Wyvern, just did so much work this game. The saves were out of this world, and every single one of them was necessary to push them forward in this game here. 45 minutes, 40 seconds, Wings Gaming take this best of three series 2-0, and they are going to be going to the LAN final with alongside LGD and Nihome. What a series, what a tournament.
Yeah, it's been amazing, and I mean, thank you, Blaze, for the chance to co-cast a few, and it's been awesome these past few days, and I mean, just well played to Wings. Guess this is why, you can understand why all the Chinese teams instantly ban at Huskar the minute you see a Dazzle pickup.
Yeah, and we're probably going to see that trend a little bit more. These heroes just have so much synergy and create a lot of havoc, obviously, but Wings, they pull out all the stops, they're able to pull through, and it's going to be C-Deck Youth that are unfortunately left empty-handed. So once again, LGD, Ehome, and Wings Gaming have now qualified for the LAN in Minsk, Belarus, and it is going to be very exciting to see them fight in the international tournament, see how they can prevail for that prize pool. And it's going to be obviously in the future that you'll have to look to that one. We're going to still round out the other regions to see who else is going to be playing at the event. But that wraps it up for China here, and we thank you guys so much for tuning in and joining us for as many Chinese games as you could. And a Perfect World, thank you for playing nice with your servers, at least for one game. It was actually very refreshing to be able to see all the action there. Anyways, yeah, that is going to be it for us here. Concluding the broadcast, I've been up since 2 a.m. I might need a nap, but it's going to be hard to calm the adrenaline after seeing all these great games of Dota 2. Thank you guys once again for tuning in. If you enjoyed the commentary, feel free to look us up. I'm at BlazeCasting on Twitter, and my wonderful co-caster, Hades, at HadesDota, and that is going to be it. See you guys next time.
Bye-bye.